The latest version of Adobe Character Animator adds some exciting new tools to bring your characters and stories to life. Inverse kinematics have been extended to the legs with the new limb IK behavior. Now characters can squat, pose, bend, and jump to add further expressiveness. Additional refinements give you more control over draggable handles, so your hands can either stay in place or follow your character's movements. Speech-aware animation, powered by Adobe Sensei, lets you automatically create head animations from an audio file. Just import an audio track and go to Timeline, Compute Head Movement from Speech. Your character's head will move around based off the dialogue, and you can adjust the parameters after computing for more fine-tuned control. Automatic lip sync has been drastically improved, leading to significantly more accurate matching mouth shapes for higher quality animation. New timeline features help make recording and editing performances a breeze. A search filter lets you quickly find the content you're looking for, while shy icons let you show or hide a custom group of takes with a single click. Merge takes lets you convert multiple lip sync or trigger takes into a consolidated single track. And the new sequence takes command lets you quickly arrange a group of takes on the timeline with specific rules. Hey everyone, this is Dave from the Adobe Character Animator team, and today I'm incredibly excited to announce the latest version of Adobe Character Animator version 3.4 is out right now. You can download it in the Creative Cloud desktop app right now. There are a ton of new enhancements and features and improvements in this release. One of the biggest of those is Limb IK. This allows your character now to bend and squat and jump and kick and all sorts of different things. Adds a lot of additional expressive options. That feature is so big that I gave it its own dedicated tutorial video. So please, on this channel, go check out the Limb IK video tutorial if you're interested in that. But this video right here, we're going to get into everything else. So we're going to talk about automatic speech-aware animation, doing some head movements. I'm going to talk about what these little shy character icons are down here and a few other timeline improvements. So we're going to go into a lot more details. So if you want to know everything that's new in 3.4, this is the video to watch. Speech-aware animation is a new feature powered by Adobe Sensei, the same machine learning AI technology stuff we use for the automatic lip sync, and allows you to take that kind of same concept, but use it for the face animation instead. So you probably have done this before where you bring an audio track into your timeline and you go to Timeline, Compute Lip Sync Take from Scene Audio. That analyzes the audio track and based off of that gives you all these different mouth shapes, your visemes, that show up in the timeline down here. Well, it's the same concept, but for the face. So what you can do is select your character and then with an audio track in here, go to Timeline, Compute Head Movement from Speech. So if you click that, it's going to start computing and analyzing all the different audio peaks and valleys, the gaps where there's silence, the amplitude, the syllables, all of that stuff, and turn that into head movement for your character automatically. So after that analysis is complete, you're going to get a new face take showing up down here in your timeline. And if I play this back, I can see that the head is moving based off of the audio that the character is saying. Now, by default, this might not look good depending on your character and your voice and a few other, you know, parameters. But the nice thing is I can change all these things in real time over here to tweak the head movement to exactly what I want. So for example, right now I feel like the head is maybe tilting a little bit too much. So I might move that down to 25% to be a little bit more subtle. Same thing with the eyebrows. They're tilting and moving a lot. So I might move that to 10 and negative 10 for the raise and the lowering. And that looks a little bit better as well. So it's a really helpful tool to get some fast head animation. Now, yeah, you can still do the traditional route, press record, do your face movements, you know, pose and pose, that sort of thing, if you want. And I'm probably going to do that for most of my puppets. But if I'm trying to get a puppet out really quick, or I've got some background characters or some other things, this is a huge time saver. And all these options you can tweak over here allow you to customize it to exactly the type of motion and animation you want. This version should also see a dramatic increase in better lip sync for the character. So we have a new algorithm working behind the scenes that should be a lot more responsive and work hopefully better for you. You can try it out, and of course you can always tweak it by going to Character Preferences on Mac, or that's Edit Preferences on PC, and go to the Lip Sync Preferences over here. If you want to see more lip sync, more viseme show up, tilt this more to the more side. If you want to see less less of them, go to less. So you've got some control there. And then if you want to go back to some old versions, you can do that as well. Or have some audio-based muting. If you have a lot of background noise, you might want to change this as well. This has always been in Character Animator for the past couple of versions, but I just want to show it to help you tweak your lip sync if you want. This is a really minor small update, but in the past, when you got off of a set rest pose, as soon as you click set rest pose, your character would immediately jump back and there'd be a stutter there and it didn't look very good. So what we've done now is when you click set rest pose, the character will kind of ease back into place instead. So don't worry if you're doing a live stream or you're recording and you want it to look good. It's okay to click set rest pose anytime and it will look smooth and gradual and not jerky like it used to. One of the areas of Character Animator that we've given the most refinement to in this release is the timeline. We know that, you know, as you're recording, the timeline can get kind of crazy with a lot of different takes and blends and all that stuff coming in, and it can sometimes be difficult to parse. And hopefully we've made a few usability improvements in that area. First off, if you just look at it, it's a little more colorful now. So it's a little bit easier to distinguish different tracks. Before, they were all the exact same shade and kind of difficult to say, okay, was this my drag or my eye gaze? Now you have different color, so I can see the lip sync here is green, this trigger is blue, and those changes will automatically update as you add new tracks. So it just helps it be a little bit more readable. Secondly, we've added shine into the timeline. And this is something, if you're used to After Effects, you might recognize this little guy, the shy guy. And what that allows you to do is anything with a shy icon over here, you can click to hide that person, that little guy peering over the edge there. And if it's hidden, then as soon as you click this hide shy icon up here, everything that had that icon down and hiding will disappear. So this makes it a lot easier to focus and concentrate on any one particular part of the timeline at any given time. And if you want to see everything again, just click on the shy guy again and you can do that. Now, the nice thing is this is very flexible, right? So if I'm done with that and now I want to move into, let's say I'm done with my draggers and I just want to focus on eye gaze, I could get rid of all of these, click the shy guy, and now just focus on that particular one. So it's very flexible and easy to move back and forth, shy things, unshy them, bring them back and forth, and just really helps the timeline become a lot easier to move around. Sometimes when you're recording in Character Animator, your timeline can get a little unwieldy, right? When you've got recording and then you stop and record again, and you get this what we call a staircase effect, where you know you have just a very vertically high timeline and it becomes difficult to see everything and make sense of it all. So what we've done is what you can do now in this latest version is select all of those takes, those disparate takes that you have, and then go to Timeline Merge Takes. And just like that, they're consolidated into a single track. This is fantastic. This will save you a lot of time and just kind of scrolling around and trying to find where things are. Currently, this is only working for lip sync and triggers. We hope to extend this to other parts in the future, but for this version, it's only gonna work if you do this for multiple lip sync tracks or trigger tracks. Another nice timeline improvement is sequence takes. So sometimes I've got several takes that I want to show up in a particular sequence. So let's say I've got a bunch of hand movements here, arm movements, that I just want to show up one right after the other. And yeah, I could manually try to drag them and get them exactly right, an overlap and all of that, but it's, you know, it's pretty cumbersome and time consuming, particularly if you have a longer recording that you've done of a character. But what I can do now is select all of these and just go to Timeline Sequence Takes. And that brings up this little dialogue that allows me to determine how these takes should be sequenced. So I could have them overlap by 5 frames or whatever value I want. I can do a negative, positive, go through here. So let's say I want to have a little bit of a blend. So let's say I want them to overlap by, I don't know, 8 frames or something like that. Click OK. And just like that, all the takes are sequenced with an 8-frame overlap. So let's try it down here with the other hand. I'll select all of these. I'm just shift selecting them, or of course you can marquee select them by clicking and dragging. Timeline, sequence takes. For this one, let's not overlap. Let's just have them go one right after the other. Click OK. And there you go, they're all just in order. So it's just a nice time saver. If you have a lot of different takes, draggers, face, eye gaze, whatever, and you want those to all be sequenced next to each other, this is just a quick way to do it. There've also been a few different things you can do with the search filter in the timeline now to help you refine stuff. And that is, my favorite one here is kind, and then a colon, and then what you're looking for. So for example, if I'm looking for takes that have keyframes in them, I can just type kind keyframe, and any takes that have keyframes will show up, or kind audio, and audio shows up, or kind puppet, and then you will get your main puppet. I think take is the other one. And then I think you can also do camera and scene as well. So it's just a nice way to refine if I'm only looking for those things with keyframes, or only looking for takes or my audio tracks or whatever. That's a really quick way to get into it. And then a super secret shortcut is if you go armed and true, it's going to show you everything that is currently armed for this character over here on this side. So if I also added eye gaze in, that's also going to show up. So just a quick way to see the things that are currently live and ready to record. Another small but helpful refinement has been added to the walk behavior. So if you've ever added a simple walking character, you've noticed that when you stop walking and then turn your head, your character is tilting all over the place, right? Because the feet have to be independent, the legs have to be independent to be able to move around. Because of that, you can't pin them to the ground like you normally would. Well, there's this new parameter down here in walking called pin feet when standing. If you click on that, then the feet are going to stay pinned to the ground regardless of whatever you do. So even when you walk and then you stop, they will stay pinned down there and they won't pivot like they previously did. So just a small quality of life thing. All right, so that is a roundup of all the new stuff that we've added in this latest release. Again, please check out that LimIK video, because that's, to me, the game changer feature in this release, and you should definitely give that a try. But all these little nice little quality of life improvements that we've added, hopefully it will make things a little bit easier in your experience using Character Animator. We'd love to see what you make with this or what you think of this release, so please use hashtag Character Animator when sharing on social media so we can check that out. And then if you have any questions about anything I've shown here today or anything problems you're running into with rigging or recording or editing or whatever, the best place to get help is the official Character Animator forums. That's it for today. Thank you so much for watching and have fun.